today we'll be talking about the Big Four. My second week, I met Corey Wise. Second thing is, I'm about to be a big brother. The third thing is, I'm practicing abstinence. If y'all don't know what abstinence is, it means that you're not having sex until marriage. And the last thing of the Big Four, we just reached 400 subscribers, man. Like this video, stay in tune for more. It's a shoot, TC Productions. Watch the whole video.
Everybody wanna fuck with me for benefits now. Man, I wish my niggas really could've seen me lit now. Sit down, maybe roll up, blow a spit down. Time go by, nigga change so much. Why the fuck these niggas looking at my chain so much?
What's good, YouTube, man? It's your boy TC Productions, man. Back with another video, man. Look, I'm not even gonna hold y'all. I think I have an info. Alright, what's good, YouTube, man? It's your boy TC Productions, man. Back with another video. If you're watching this video, man, make sure you hit that thumbs up button, man. And if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button, man. We just hit 400 subscribers, man. We're growing. Alright, so, yeah, college been going great, man. In my third week, you already know, man. This week went by fast, man. How was everybody Labor Day? You feel me? I know I went back home. I had fun going back home. Let me get back to the first thing about going back home. Okay, so as some of you may not know, I have a little brother on the way. Yes, sir. I have a little brother on the way, man. Finally happened. I want to put all my business out there, but like, so my mama, she had a lot of miscarriages, you know, after she had me, and even before she had me. So I was kind of like a miracle child, you feel me? My mama, after 18 years, you feel me, of me coming out, now another one, you feel me? So, you feel me, I left, now another one finna come. So this week, she had a baby shower, and I was so glad. So, the weekend, Labor Day weekend, 3 days out, I got to go. And it was nice. I'm ready to be a big brother. She having a boy. Hey, guess what the name is, though? Cameron. So you know how I'm recording, you feel me? It's a shoot, always with the camera. Now my brother's name is Cameron. You feel me? You feel me? I like this hat, bro. I really do like this hat. But I'm gonna wear it to the side, though. Because you feel me from the nap. But anyways, man, I'm so happy, and I'm blessed. And I'm gonna say, bro, just thank you to God, you feel me? Like, I can do something good and positive so I can not just impact other people, but also a little brother as well, which is something so great, you feel me? You already know, you feel me? I'm gonna be there, you feel me? Hold a little bro hand, you feel me? The whole nine, you feel me? I'm happy about that. Alright, so now to the part of meeting Corey Wise. So, I met Corey Wise, when was that? Last Monday? Yeah. It was after class. When I came to Ball State, I was at the activity fair. A woman came up to me. She said, come to her church. She'll be having Corey Wise speak as a guest speaker. So I was like, hey, what? I'm there. You feel me? I was going to be there anyway because it's church. But, Corey Wise had showed up. Oh, yeah. Also with BSU Impact. If you're a Ball State student, and you're African American, get involved with BSU Impact, man. I'm telling you, get involved with Impact. So I met Corey Wise. He came, he spoke to us, he talked about, just watch the movie, you feel me? You really don't need him to say anything else. Just like watching that movie, you feel me, is heartbreaking. It tells a lot. It tells a lot about what the brothers went through, and it takes a lot of them boys didn't commit that crime and they got punished for something that they didn't do. And we still see that today, and we still see it in today's generation, that people are just, you feel me, being punished for crimes they didn't commit. And especially if you're a black African-American and someone else, we was talking about this in my criminology class. If a Caucasian person and an African-American commit the same crime, an African-American will do more time than a Caucasian person. Just because he's African-American and the statistics, you feel me, don't want to see him win, you feel me? So, yeah, so that's how it is. But meeting Corey Wise, you feel me, was a great, great experience. I really just, you feel me, I felt his energy, you feel me? Man, I just can't explain it. It was just like hearing him talk and hearing how he got through that situation was like uplifting. It was uplifting for me. Saying that, like, dang, somebody really got out of that tough situation. It's almost like he spread his testimony. You know what I'm saying? Do I need to speak more on Corey Wise? It was just like a great experience. And everybody wanted to hear me talking about some, where was he at, and all that. But I ain't hear from y'all, like, you feel me, a whole year. I ain't finna hit y'all up, you feel me? I ain't finna tell y'all where I was at. Cause now y'all wanna hear my phone, you feel me, now that I'm taking a picture with Celeste. But you know, I've been doing that. But I've been taking pictures with Celeste, you feel me? If you don't know me, you feel me? Go check out my IG, you feel me? But I really don't put all my pictures on IG. But I took a couple pictures with a lot of Celeste, you feel me? Like a name, you feel me, and go all day with it. But a nigga gonna be famous, you feel me, one day. Big facts. Alright, so that's my second thing. My third thing, let's move on to number three. It's a hard one. It's not hard, but it's just like TC, how you focus on that? Like TC is so different. TC Productions is different, you feel me? It ain't with an S, it's with a Z, you feel me? That's how different we are. My goodness. All right, so third thing. Absence. Okay. How did I come up to figuring out absence? Okay. I say about in the 11th grade, getting closer to my senior year, something turned me on to, like, I think I was just, I don't know what I was doing, but something caught my attention to someone talking about celibacy and absence. So, watching a couple of videos about, like, people speaking on how it impacts their marriage and how it helps the relationship or how it helps them find their partner, you feel me, that they really want to grow with. So I always had it in mind that I wanted to be, you feel me, absent. Just never, you feel me, I didn't actually put it forth. So, yes, I'm committed absence with a partner right now. You know, y'all can go check out me and her videos. But really, absence is like a soul thing. So, it's spiritual. A lot of people don't think that soul ties is real. Or they do think it's real, but they just don't think about it. So, soul ties is real. It's a real thing. And once you have sex with a person, y'all mind intertwine, y'all spirits start intertwining, and sometimes, really all the time, y'all spirits become one, and y'all not even married yet. Y'all just doing something that's temporary, that don't even last long. Sex don't last long, you feel me? It's only temporary, it's only one night, it's a one night stand, you feel me? And that's not your partner. And in the Bible, you're not supposed to have sex with someone if you don't marry them. So I don't know. I'm trying to become very, very religious. I am religious, you feel me, Christian. But I find myself more in college. I find myself more growing with God. I grow more in God because I'm here by myself. I'm trying to learn of myself. I'm not going to church as much. So me and God has to become one like this. So the reason why I'm coming absence is because it's a couple of reasons. Saving myself for the person that I want. Second is, it's a lot of things going on out here. Like, ain't nobody trying to be having that.
Got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that.
And third is just, overall, what do I want as a family? Like, I have to look at the next 6, 8, 10 years of my life and thinking about what do I actually want? What do I want for myself? What do I want for my family, my wife, my kids? What do I want overall? What do I want my financial status to look at? And I believe that being absent will help me get to where I want to go in the next 8 to 10 years, you feel me? Some people don't think like that. Some people don't think that, you feel me, thinking about your future is like, it's like crazy. Like, why are you thinking the past next 10 years? Why? Because I want something for myself. So that's the reason why, man, pray for me, man, as I go on this journey for the next 6, 8, 4, however many years of me being Athens, man. Pray for me, man, because I need that strength. But yeah, it be hard, man. I ain't even gonna hold you, man. Like, temptation is a bug, bro. Temptation is a bug. Like, I ain't gonna lie to y'all, you feel me? I'm a man, you feel me? A man has weaknesses, you feel me? And women do too, but like, absence, I think, is gonna help me grow in faith, grow with myself, learn myself, and it'll help me all around with financially, mentally, all that other stuff that come with it. So, I think I got that discussion based. My last topic. I don't think y'all ready for this. I don't think they ready. I still don't think y'all ready. Y'all ready? 400 subscribers on YouTube, man. I'm saying it like that's like that's a big number. Man, you know what? It is a big number. It's a big number to me because, hey, every YouTuber got their ups and every YouTuber got their downs, you feel me? I'm looking at it like this. I never know when I could blow up on YouTube. Like, it could be the next 3 years, it could be the next 2 years, it could be the next 6. But whenever it comes, that's my time. You feel me? That's my time. So I'm looking at 400 subscribers right now. And God may say in the next 3 years, you may have 100,000. And the grind may pay off. Like, don't stop just because you only at 400 or you only at 100 or you only at 300. You feel me? Don't stop because your time will come. Your time eventually will come. So I'm just thankful of hitting 400 subscribers, growing the audience, talking to the people that I can reach out to. Basically, what I have planned after reaching this 400, I erased it. But what I have planned is more public interviews, more collabs. I know a couple people who want to start getting a YouTube channel started. So I feel like if I can brainstorm some ideas to do with those individuals, and you know, I'm trying to get some friends here at Ball State. I know a lot of people, but I want to bring y'all into the videos and stuff like that. So, I feel like I should have scooted the camera over anyway. But anyways, I do have more videos coming. I'm going to drop another video in a minute. So I just want to say thank you guys. That's the end to this video, the Big Four. Man, I had a speech to do today, y'all. I think I did well, man. I had to go first, man. But that was my first college speech. I got the video. I'll probably drop that, you feel me? I don't know, but the teacher said it take like 2 weeks to grade, so. But anyways, man, thank y'all for watching this video, man. Thank y'all for 400 subscribers, man. Thank y'all for watching me, if you new, or even if you old, man. Thank y'all for, you feel me, just staying in tune, cause the grind gonna pay off, man. Eventually it's gonna pay off. So again, thank y'all. Make sure you guys like this video. Make sure you subscribe if you're not subscribed. And turn on post notifications, man. It's a shoot, We're coming with more bang.
It's 54.
See my wrist down. Everybody wanna fuck with me for benefits now. Man, I wish my niggas really could've seen me lit now. Sit down, maybe roll up, blow a spit down. Time go by, nigga change so much. Why the fuck these niggas looking at my chain so much?